Hi there.
Mr. O'Leary,
yes.
There is an incident from your Dragon's Den days where you were seen grabbing a woman's butt who is advertising some gene technology that makes your ass look good. I'm wondering if this was your idea to grab this woman's butt on television.
Well, there's about 10,000 hours of tape. I've had a long career in television. And I think you're going to find pieces of it chopped up into all kinds of incontextual moments, such as the one you're suggesting. I think you should actually go watch that whole show. Not at all, but my point is that in the end of the day, that is television. It's not policy. This is a different world we're in here. We're talking about an economy that's collapsing. No jobs for millennials, and you want to talk about reality TV?
I'm giving you a platform to give me the context.
No, but I suggest you watch all of the Dragon's Den shows and watch how the products are presented.
Ask that woman permission before you grabbed her bum.
I honestly don't remember, but I'm sure she wasn't offended. She was obviously trying to sell a deal to a bunch of dragons, and I hope she was successful. At the end of the day, she was an entrepreneur seeking capital. I'm very proud of that format and what we did for Canadian men and women. As a matter of fact, my most successful deals now, after 10 years of being an investor on this format, are all companies run by women. They've returned all of their capital, over 40 different companies. It's the women-run ones that have been successful. So I'm a big supporter of women entrepreneurs. That's on the record. I've had some phenomenal successes with them. They're better managers, that's why, and that's good. But that, again, I don't know how that helps us grow this economy to 3%.
You're basically auditioning to be prime minister of the country. So
yes, I am. And I think I'll do a great job bringing those entrepreneurs and those millennials. Let me point something out to you. You know, in order for this party to win a majority mandate, it's that young woman, along with all of her cohorts, that have to vote for conservatives. And in order to get them back into this party, we have to be able to communicate with them. Now, where do they exist and why was Trudeau so successful? In universities, on campuses, in institutions where they gather as entrepreneurs and aspire to grow. That's what they want to do. We have not had a conservative candidate in the last 10 years that will get an audience with them. When I showed up at UBC and McGill in the last 2 weeks, hundreds of them came out. And what did we talk about? Their future. Now, the ability to gather them in a forum and have a dialogue about their future and make sure they understand the peril they're in today under Justin Trudeau, who many of them voted for, is the challenge of this party. I have to drag them back into the Conservative Party. And the way I'm doing it is showing them the math. They are forgoing their opportunity. They're forgoing their future. They're getting buried in debt by an irresponsible prime minister who misunderstood his mandate.
But what about your character, sir? I mean, we're asking you a question, and you're avoiding the question.
Not at all. I think my character is defined by what I say and what I do as a candidate for this party.
You are as a person.
Listen, I am very involved in all kinds of formats of television. I make great television. Think about Amanda Lang, 6,000 hours of tape with her. Very controversial, exploring all kinds of different ideas, not policy. Canadians aren't stupid. Some of that tape is so old, I had hair. So at the end of the day, you're going to see it dragged out by liberals, but they're going to be able to distinguish the difference between what is great television and what is policy.